Yo, what's up, good peoples? It's your man Chris Thorns. As always, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Whenever you're watching my content, as always, like, comment, and subscribe. Ladies and gentlemen, you already know what this is. So take a look at this, and I'll be back with my thoughts.
Truck. We just need to get people over to the hospital, okay?
Okay. Go ahead. Put them all in the back.
Okay. Can you pull over towards the side over there? You know what? This person right here. Hold up. Hold up. Can we get this person in here?
Baby, this is horrible.
Yeah. Hold on. Try it now.
Oh my God.
Hey, it's Jake reporting from the Delano Metley Bay, where the police have an active shooter.
Through investigation and response, we determined there was a shooter on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay. Officers responded to that location and engaged the suspect at that location. He is dead. Currently, he has been identified. He is a local resident.
You're American bread and butter people that are out there and they're shot by some senseless guy. And it's so unfortunate to hear about that.
First of all, Fred Use, this is not my content. What's so weird about this story to me is a lot of y'all know that I lost my grandmother back in August. And I kid you not, I just had a dream about her last night going into this morning. Just had a dream about her. And wake up and see this story, see somebody posted it in my group, this story right here. And got up and saw the videos and read about it, and I'm just like, oh, wow. So I don't know if grandmother was coming to my dream and tell me, that, hey, wake up, you know, look what's going on. Cause I see what you've been doing. And you need to talk about this. I'm guessing that's what she was telling me. But I said I was going to do it regardless of what. It's kind of hard for me to do it. I just actually did a live stream on Facebook about this. So I said, since I gave Facebook something, you know, why not give YouTube something as well? Okay. So here's my thoughts about this whole thing right here. There's a message that we're missing. There's a message that we're missing. Hold on, let me there's a message that we're missing, and we just can't see the writing on the wall. Think about it. We'd have had 3 back-to-back hurricanes. Puerto Rico got hit. Okay? Texas got hit. Then Florida got hit. It may be 4. I may be missing one more, but I don't know. Y'all correct me if I did. Then you see me do the story about the guy in Nashville who shot up the church. Then y'all saw me when I did a story about the young man who they attempted to lynch him. And now this. So again, there is a message that we are missing and we can't see the writing on the wall. I'm going to limb and say that the message is the end of days are near. I'm not a religious guy. I'm not a person that goes to church. Any of that stuff. I'm even not a conspiracy theorist, however the fuck you want to call them. But on this right here, for those of you who believe in conspiracy, I had to give you a pass on this one. I think there's something else going on here. There's something real serious going on here. And I do believe it means that the end of days are coming, if they're not here already. Just think about this. All last week, and all throughout that week that the hurricane hit, it was something that happened every fucking day. Every fucking day. Then come to find out, a ex-Facebook friend of mine, they lost their life Saturday. So it's something in the food, something in the air, something in the water. I mean, I don't know what the fuck it is, but it's something there. There's something there. It says this man had 11 guns or multiple guns, however. And they say he was checked in the hotel room since the 28th of last month. So he's been plotting this. So the question was asked, you know, how is he able to get that many guns? I mean, it's easy, you know. I mean, from my understanding, if you got a clean background, it's easy to purchase guns. If you got a license to get one or a permit, it's easy to get ones. Hell, you find a motherfucker on the street selling them motherfuckers, you can get it. It's not hard. And I think the easiest one is to get it from motherfuckers in the streets, because you don't have to have shit to buy from them. So to ask that question, I mean, it's easy for anybody to get a gun. Or multiple guns. You understand? So, you know, with that, that's a question that should even be asked. You know what I mean? This shit is happening. Then this brother, I don't even know what you call him a brother. I don't know what the fuck to call him. But he turned around and took his own life like a lot of you motherfuckers do. They sit there and kill a whole lot of people. Then turn around and take their own fucking life, you know, like a bitch, you know. Last I checked, it was a total of 58 people that were dead and I think over 400 injured. But I'm pretty much sure the count is still going up and up and up. So while we around here fucking with other folks via cyberbullying or bullying in real life, trying to flag people content, fucking with folks, threatening their kids and wishing death on somebody else and all that bullshit, y'all need to wake up and realize that you're hurting yourself in the same. Because you know, like they say, be careful what you wish for, or you just might get it. And karma is a bitch. And misery loves company. And misery touched down in L.A. Or Las Vegas, rather. Misery touched down in Las Vegas. And that motherfucker got a whole lot of company came with it. People, we need to wake up. Not just blacks, but people in general. We need to wake the fuck up. Because we about to meet something. I don't know what the fuck it is, but we going to meet something at the end of the day. I wish death on nobody, not even my own enemies. Again, because you wish that shit, it happens to you. It happens to you. You best believe that shit. You best believe that shit. Hey, y'all know what? I'm going to tell you what the funny thing about this is. And I'm going to get on out of here. this shit right here is going on, and people still gonna be trying to play the detective on Kanika Jenkins. And she's finally been laid to rest, but people still gonna be trying to play detective in her death. We probably gonna find a whole lot of people ain't gonna say shit about this. But for the people who are talking about this, hey, salute to y'all. Because this stuff needs to be talked about. This is a serious matter. Okay? And speaking of Kanika, I don't know if y'all seen it, the video they did about the funeral. All I'm gonna say this right here. I ain't gonna get into all that because I'm done talking about her situation. All I'm gonna say is this right here. That was the most disgusting funeral I ever seen. I never seen a funeral like that. To me, it was a misrepresentation of us as black, period. And I also feel like it was a misrepresentation of her. Anytime you go into a funeral and you see somebody get on top of the car and start twerking, this is how you represent your dead friend or your dead family member? This is how you represent them? By wearing short, tight shit and twerking and acting a damn fool? This is how we represent our lost ones now? Apparently so. But I can tell you this, I'm glad I ain't part of that family, period. My grandma died, I wouldn't dare sit up there and represent my grandma like that. Especially my grandmother. I wouldn't dare represent her like that, having all these dumbass idiots doing the shit they was doing. But anyway, this ain't about her. I just threw it up in there as my two cents. But people, we do need to wake up, because there's something serious out here going on. And it's time for us to wake up. Hell, it's been time for us to wake up. Because misery is winning. Karma is winning. All this shit is winning. But instead of speaking on it or doing something on it, we spending our time fucking with everybody else. Wishing death on them. Wishing death on their kids. And all that other shit in between. Instead of looking at what the real shit is going on now. Sad days coming, people. And some tell me this ain't the worst. We gonna see something worse than this. But in that, like I said, I had a dream. My grandma came in my dream. I believe this is what she was trying to tell me. Evidently, she must be up there looking at me doing what I do, and maybe she like what I do. So I did it, Grandmama. I did it. And I wish it's something else. I wish it's something I could have done to prevent this, but of course, you know I can't. You know I can't. So anyway, rest in peace to the family out there, and a speedy recovery to the people who are in the hospital. Wish y'all a speedy recovery. And that's all I really got to say about it. It's a sad, tragic accident. And again, we ain't seen the worst yet. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. Leave your thoughts. And I'll talk to y'all later. Peace out.